Hare Om. Let's start with the prayer. Om Samasta Jana Kalyani Niratam Karunamayam Namami Chinmayam Devam Sadgurum Brahma Vidvaram Vasudeva Sutam Devam Kamsachanura Mardhanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Vande Jagadgurum Tvameva Mata Cha Pitatvameva Tvameva Bandhusya Sakatvameva Tvameva Vidyadravidam Tvameva Tvameva Sarvam Mama Deva Deva Tvameva Sarvam Guru Deva Deva. Hari Om. So another common question that is being asked in many Vedantic discussions is, what is a soul? Is there really a soul? Because I don't see any soul. All I see is body, mind, body itself, and I infer there is a mind and intellect and so on, depending upon how he thinks and so on and so forth. But is there a soul? And I don't believe it. So this is always a common question, and whenever I say, the question is, yes, I cannot see soul, because it's not that we can see by through perceptual process. That's number one. So just because I don't see, I cannot say it's not there. So it's not a belief system. Do I see mind? Do I see your thought? Oh, I don't know. I don't believe in thought. I don't believe in our mind. I don't believe in my mind. So these are the statements. Just because I cannot, I don't see, doesn't mean, does not mean that it's not there. So the basis of the existence or proof of existence is not based on the fact that I'm able to see or detect or do something based on the observations of the objective observations. So one fellow went to Ramana Maharshi and said, I heard you have seen God, please show me. Ramana Maharshi says, even if I show you, you won't know. No, I have infrared camera, this camera, that camera, I can capture. I say, okay, this is God. So I say, what are you doing? You are putting finger back and forth. So I told you, you cannot see. So what makes this matter with all carbohydrates, minerals and all that so dynamic, so alive, that X factor, a factor, X presence of which this body, which is essentially a matter and is becoming so dynamic and alive, and without that X factor, it's dead and gone. The moment that life leaves, that body starts stinking. And in fact, you have to get rid of the body as quickly as possible, and the United States police come here to make sure that the body is immediately removed out of the place and put it in a proper place in the whatever that places are. So therefore, that factor, that X factor, which we call is soul, or the very life principle that makes this matter so dynamic. I dump all sorts of things into my stomach and then sleep. But whatever that factor makes my body to function in such a way, the proper digestive system, all juices have to come in a proper order, enzymes and everything are put in a proper order, and the body has to be, the digestion has to occur, and the digested food that gets absorbed, and every cell in the body has a wonderful distribution system, has to get nourishment so that the cells can function properly. It's an amazing how the machine works, but all that works only because of that factor X, which we don't know what it is, but without which the body is dead and gone. We'll say, hey, the fellow is dead and gone. What does it mean? Everybody uses that word in Hindi, mar gaya. That means there was somebody who was there, left the body. So a presence of that makes the body alive, and the absence of it makes the body dead. Where does it go? Of course, it goes where it wants to find a different place where it can use the proper body for its functions. So it is there in this body because this body is conducive for its transactional purposes, so that it can get what it wants. So what does it want? It wants happiness. Obviously, that's what we said. The purpose of life is happiness. So that soul is searching for happiness. and it wants to leave this body because this body is no more suitable, just like a dead car or car that is no more functioning, and you want to buy a new car. And so Gita Upadesha starts. Gita started listening because Arjuna thought the body is the person that is going to get killed. It's not a body. X factor, and he is not going to get died. That's what Krishna starts. Natti moham jatanasam natvam nemi janalipaha. That's why even abhavishyamaha. So they are never a person, never a time I was not there, never a time you were not there, never a time all these kings you thought is going to be died will be there. They will be there eternally. So where does he go? When the soul goes in search of place where he can find a better body to transact what? To get again happiness, because searching for happiness all the time. And that goes on life after life after life, searching for happiness, and that transfer of that moves into that. So when the death occurs, it packs all these things that he needed, and the package includes the mind, intellect, and all the tendencies and all that, and packs the whole package, leaving just a matter of carbohydrates, minerals and everything else right there. So is there a soul in the restaurant? The fact that you are able to ask that question means that you are alive, and the what factor that makes you alive is that soul, we call it, and that's essentially what Vedanta also tells. With that we stop here. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi.